Mother Jones wrote an excellent piece about how GlaxoSmithKline gave incredible perks to physicians in order to overprescribe some of their drugs and also prescribe their drugs for off-label uses that were not approved by the FDA. Now, one of the drugs that GlaxoSmithKline launched is something known as Advair, and one of the things that they market it for is asthma medication. Well, I want to show you a video of them launching the product in Vegas in 2001, and it gives you an idea of what kind of environment they create for these physicians. Let's watch.
Y'all ready for this?
Who wants to be a millionaire? Let's. The more you sell, the more you make. There are people in this room who are going to make an ungodly sum of money selling Advair. That's the way it should be. God bless America. Free enterprise is a wonderful concept.
So the person speaking there was Advair's product manager, Jim Daly. He was talking to physicians about making money. Now, the problem is they were making money by selling drugs that the FDA was telling them, don't sell it for that purpose. It's not authorized for that purpose. In fact, it was supposed to be a first-line therapy for mild asthma patients. That's just flat out what it was supposed to be, let alone the uses that they put that it wasn't supposed to be for, and the FDA had flatly rejected it, giving it a black box warning that deaths had halted the clinical trials. So yes. Here he is saying, you know, God bless free enterprise, let's sell this thing that might kill people, yay!
This story immediately caught my attention, especially because it had to do with Advair. I was prescribed Advair because I had a chronic cough a few years ago. How is Advair going to help a chronic cough? And I mean, I was young. I mean, I don't know. I'm not going to research the drug. The doctor said take it, and I took it, and it did absolutely nothing for my chronic cough, by the way.
Now, speaking of the young, they wanted to push off-label uses. Now, the FDA made it very clear. You cannot use this if you're under 18. Do not prescribe it to that. Well, how did they get beyond that? They, in Boston, for example, on a yacht called Tranquility, they would bring doctors on and they would give them all these perks, and then they would bring in child psychiatrists and say, now if you did want to prescribe it to people under 18, these are all the lovely benefits of it. I mean, the FDA doesn't agree, of course, but you could do it anyway, and by the way, you're on a yacht, and if you'd like, we can give you a massage. By the way, literally.
Yeah, so let me tell you some of the perks that they received. Decades worth of physician kickbacks, fraudulent marketing, and various other kinds of legal and ethical boundaries have been breached, which is why they settled this case with the Department of Justice for $3 billion. Also, they would give doctors basketball tickets, GlaxoSmithKline-sponsored yacht trips, payments made to Dr. Drew Pinsky, which is interesting, and also deep tissue massages. Also, when it came to the Paxil Forum, they held that in Puerto Rico, Hawaii, and California, and it included deep sea fishing, kayaking, snorkeling, sailing, horseback riding, and balloon rides.
Now, those were all the different places they would have it, so that, you know, you'd be like, oh, would you like to come to Hawaii and go kayaking with us? If you play ball and you happen to prescribe it off-label and we all get rich, the doctor gets rich, we get rich, and if the, you know, client happens to suffer, well, sad day for them. They didn't make it on the yacht trip. By the way, the list is endless. NASCAR races, Knicks games, Celtics games, tennis lessons, Crosby, Stills, and Nash tickets, pheasant hunting. Okay, all the ways they would bribe the doctors to do this to their own patients.
One of the GlaxoSmithKline employees wrote in an email to his sales team that they needed to focus on the return of investment. And he wrote, for the return of investment, it's imperative only key customers, referring to physicians, attend these valuable venues.
Now, do you understand why they do that? If you don't play ball, you don't get to go to the basketball game. I mean, the Celtics games are very expensive. That's the one they were referring to in that particular instance. So if we're going to get a good return on investment from you, and you're going to peddle this to all your patients, whether they need it or not, then you get the tickets to the Celtics game. If you're not going to do that, then you don't get to go to the game.
Yeah. And another thing that I found really interesting is that within their employees, there was one 23-year-old veteran of the company by the name of Greg Thrope.
He'd been there for 23 years. He's a sales rep, okay? So he's a senior guy. He's been selling all this time. And then he says this.
He got contacted not by a physician, but by a physician's assistant demanding the following. Number one, a 65-minute deep tissue massage. Two, a 60-minute Colorado cleansing facial, which I don't know what that is, but it sounds interesting. And number three, a 30-minute foot reflexology. And four, a pedicure and a French manicure. He was so outraged by this that he wrote in the email where he was complaining, I want to promote the benefits of my products, but this even sickens me.
He's saying basically, look, I'm willing to do a lot of things, but we've gotten so far, even I'm repulsed by this. Now, one of my favorite parts was in 2006, Arkansas's Medicaid program had restricted the coverage of how you would cover this because you had to give a warning saying, hey, you might not need this. And in fact, they had shown through trials that that was more effective. It didn't hurt anybody, and it only got to the patients that it needed to get to. So obviously, they had to eliminate this because it helped patients, but it hurt their bottom line.
Right.
So what do? They basically give an untold sum of money, campaign donations, to an Arkansas lawmaker, and he introduces legislation to make sure that the patients are not protected, but the profits of GlaxoSmithKline are protected. Because as I tell you over and over, he doesn't work for you, he works for them. They're the ones who pay his campaign donations. And then you get this great quote from a GlaxoSmithKline employee, God save political donations.